everyone, welcome to Sahu Education. Dear student, today we will discuss some of the questions of exercise 8.1 of quadrilaterals which we left in the previous classes. So let us come to question number 7. It's given your ABCDG rhombus so that the diagonal AC bisects A angle as well as C angle and diagonal BD bisects B angle as well as D angle. So, first we'll draw a diagram. Let ABCD is a rhombus. So, here in ABCD, the sides are equal as a diagonal and we'll join AC diagonal as well as BD diagonal. So they meet at or bisect at O. Okay. So we'll write down and give in ABCD J rhombus where AC and BD are two diagonals. ABCD is a rhombus where AC and BD are diagonals. So we have to prove AC bisects A angle as well as C angle BD bisects B angle as well as D angle. So we will write to prove AC bisects A angle as well as C angle and BD bisects B angle as well as B angle. Okay. Then next we'll come to proof part. So see here we'll mention BAC angle as 1, BCA angle as 2 and DCA angle as 3, then DAC angle as 4. Okay, now we'll prove as in the triangle ABC, AB and BC are equal because the sides of a rhombus are equal. So we'll write down AB equal to BC. In triangle ABC, AB equal to BC sides of rhombus, sides of rhombus are equal. So I have written AB equal to BC. And one theorem already we know, the sides which are equal in a triangle, their opposite angles are equal also. So as AB equal to BC, their opposite angles are equal. Therefore, one angle equal to two angle. Now we'll see here AB parallel to CD and AC is the diagonal or the transversal. So we can say one angle equal to three angle as alternate angle. So again, one angle equal to three angle as alternate angle. So we see here one angle equal to two angle, one angle equal to again three angle. This implies two angle equal to three angle. Two angle equal to three angle, that means we can say AC bisects C angle. Therefore AC bisects C angle. Angle C. Again, we can say AD parallel to BC and AC is the transversal, that's why 2 angle equal to 4 angle. AD parallel to BC, AC is the transversal, that implies 2 angle equal to 4 angle, 2 angle equal to 4 angle alternate angle. Again, previously we know 1 angle equal to 2 angle. This is 1, suppose. Then this is 3. So from 1 and 3, we will write down from 1 and 3. In 1, we proved 1 angle equal to, and here we proved 2 angle equal to 4 angle. From 1 and 3, we know 1 angle equal to 4 angle. This implies, therefore, we can say, therefore, AC bisects A angle. Similarly, we can prove BD bisects B angle B as well as angle D. Proved. Come to question number 8. Here ABCD is a rectangle in which diagonal AC bisects A angle as well as C angle. We have to prove ABCD is a square, and second, BD bisects B angle as well as D angle. Okay. Now, we will draw a trigram of a rectangle. Let it be ABCD and AC and BD are two diagonals. So, we will write down, give him ABCD is a rectangle, okay, where AC bisects angle A as well as angle C. Okay, this was given. We have to prove ABCD is a square. ABCD is a square, and BD bisects B angle as well as D angle. Okay, so we'll given here AC bisects A angle as well as C angle. So ABCD is a rectangle, so opposite angles are equal, definitely. So A angle equal to C angle. Now we will write in proof as ABCD is a rectangle, so A angle equal to C angle. Half of A angle equal to half of C angle. Half of A angle we can say DAC equal to DCA. Okay. Again given AC bisects, AC bisects angle A and angle C. Okay. This is given and we got DAC equal to DCA. AC bisects A angle and C angle. This implies the opposite sides related to the equal angle are equal, that is AD equal to DC or CD. Okay, but as it is a rectangle, so opposite sides are equal. As ABCD is a rectangle, so AD equal to BC and CD equal to AB. So therefore we can write AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to DA. Hence ABCD is a square. Okay, we already proved ABCD is a square. Next have to prove BD bisects B angle as well as C angle. So again we'll see here BD divides ABCD square into two triangles. So in triangle ABD and BCD, we'll first write here in triangle ABD. So in triangle ABD, you see AB equal to AD. AB equal to AD. As now ABCD is a square already we proved. So their opposite angles are equal. That is ABD angle equal to ADB angle. Okay. ABD angle equal to ADB angle. But we know ADB angle equal to CBD angle. These two angles are equal. Why? Because we can say AD parallel to BC and BD is the transversal, so they are alternate angles. We can write AD parallel to BC and BD is the transversal. Okay, as BD is the transversal, this implies ADB angle, ADB angle equal to CBD angle, alternate angle, alternate angles. Okay, so we see here ABD equal to ADB, ABD equal to ADB and ADB equal to CBD. That's why we can say this implies therefore ABD angle equal to ABD angle equal to CBD angle. Okay, therefore we can say BD bisects B angle. Therefore BD bisects B angle. Similarly we can say BD bisects B angle. Similarly, we can prove BD bisects B angle. Hence proved. Let us come to question number 9. You are given in parallelogram ABCD, two points P and Q are taken on diagonal BD such that DP equal to BQ, so that APD triangle equal to CBQ triangle and AP equal to CQ. Again, width given triangle AQB, is equal to CPD and AQ equal to CP. And APCQ is a parallelogram, we have to prove that. Okay, so we'll write down given. In given, we'll write ABCD is a parallelogram. Where BQ equal to PD. This much. Given, we'll have to prove bit 1, triangle APD equal to triangle CQB, bit 2, AP equal to CQ, bit 3, triangle AQB equal to triangle CPD, bit 4, AQ equal to CP, and final bit B is APCQ is a parallelogram. Now we'll prove first bit 1. So it's given in triangle APD and CBQ or CQB, triangle APD and triangle CQB. What are the common points? We'll write BC equal to AD. BC equal to AD. Opposite sides of a parallelogram. Then we'll write BQ equal to PD. It's given. Okay. Then we can say CBQ angle equal to ADP angle. CBQ angle equal to ADP angle, alternate angles. We already proved three points common to both two triangle. So we'll write the triangle ADP, therefore triangle APD congruence to triangle CQB by SAS. Okay, now these two triangles are congruent. So by simplicity, we can say AP equal to CQ. So this implies AP equal to CQ by simplicity. So second point proved. Now we'll prove in between triangle AQB and CPD. So in triangle AQB and triangle CPD. AQB and CPD, we know AB equal to CD. Okay? AB equal to CD as opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. and then given BQ equal to PD, given, next we can prove ABD angle or ABQ angle, ABQ angle equal to CDP angle, CDP angle, then alternate angles. So we can say, therefore, triangle AQB parallel to triangle CPD by SAS criteria. This implies AQ equal to PC. Fourth point two. Now we see in quadrilateral APCQ, opposite sides are equal. So the quadrilateral whose opposite sides are equal is a parallelogram. So in quadrilateral APCQ, AQ equal to CP and CQ equal to AP. AQ equal to CP and CQ equal to AP. Hence, APCQ is a parallelogram. Proved. Here given ABCD is a parallelogram and AP and CQ are perpendicular to from vertices A and C to the diagonal BD, and we have to prove BD AP B triangle as well as triangle CQD are equal and AP equal to CQ. Okay, now we'll write down given first. Here we'll write ABCD is a parallelogram. So here and we'll write AP perpendicular to BD and CQ perpendicular to BD. Okay, then to prove, two points are given. There is triangle APB equal to triangle CQD, B AP equal to CQ. Then come to proof part. Here in proof, we have to see between in triangle APB and triangle CQD. APB, CQD. What are common things? AB equal to CD as opposite sides of a parallelogram. Okay. Next we'll see angle CDP equal to angle ABQ, alternate angles. Again, we'll say CQD angle equal to APB angle equal to 90 degrees perpendicular from A and C vertices to the diagonal BD. So we'll write down CD equal to AB opposite sides. of parallelogram. Parallelogram. Next, we'll see APB angle equal to CQD angle. CQD angle equal to 90 degree. As AP perpendicular to BD and CQ perpendicular to BD. Okay. Next is CDP angle. CDP angle equal to ABQ angle. ABQ angle alternate angle. So triangle APB congruent to triangle CQB by AAS criteria. This implies AP equal to CQ by simplicity. Hence proved. Okay. You are given in 11. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, AB equal to DE and AB parallel to DE. Again given BC equal to EF and BC parallel to EF. What is this? ABC and are joined to what is this? DEF. Already given. We have to prove between quadrilateral ABED, quadrilateral ABED is a parallelogram, then between quadrilateral BEFC, BEFC is a parallelogram, with 3 AD parallel to CF and AD equal to CF, then bit 4 will prove ADFC is a or ACFD is a parallelogram, bit 5 AC equal to BF and triangle ABC congruent to triangle DEF. Okay, this is to prove. Now we'll come to proof part directly. So here, as we know, it's given in quadrilateral ABED. ABED, it's given AB equal to DE, AB equal to DE and AB parallel to DE. Hence, this implies AB DE is a parallelogram. As we know, the quadrilateral whose opposite sides are equal as parallel is a parallelogram. So ABED is a parallelogram. This implies AD equal to AD equal to BE and AD parallel to BE. This is equation 1. Okay. Now again we'll prove in quadrilateral BCFE, in quadrilateral BCFE or BEFC, in quadrilateral BCFE, we know it's already given BC equal to EF and BC parallel to EF. As same condition, opposite sides are equal and parallel to each other, hence it is a parallelogram. This implies BC AP is a parallelogram. Okay, so this implies BC AP is a parallelogram. So we can write this implies BC BE parallel to CA and BE equal to CA. This is 2. Now from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, what we saw here, AD parallel to BE and BE parallel to CA. So we can say CF parallel to AD. This implies AD parallel to CF. And we know AD equal to BE and CF equal to BE. So AD equal to CF and AD equal to CF. B3 2 2. Now we'll say in quadrilateral ACFD, in quadrilateral ACFD, same condition, AD parallel to CA and AD equal to CA, that is proved. As proved, this implies ACFD is a parallelogram because opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. So next, as already we proved it's a parallelogram, so this opposite sides are definitely equal. So we can say AC, this implies AC equal to DA. Okay, bit 5 is proved. Now we'll see in triangle ABC and DEF. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, what are the common? We'll say AB equal to DE given. Okay, then BC equal to EF, BC equal to EF, this is also given. Okay, then we can say AC equal to DF, AC equal to DF, that is proved. Okay, hence we can say triangle ABC congruence to triangle DEA by SSS criteria. Hence, true. In 12, it's given ABCD is a trapezium in which AB parallel to CD and AD equal to BC, so that angle A equal to angle B, angle C equal to angle D, and triangle ABC is equal to or congruence to triangle BAD. Okay. Next, diagonal AC equal to diagonal BD. So let us write given. ABCD is a trapezium where AB parallel to CD and AD equal to BC. Then we have to prove beat 1, A angle equal to B angle, beat 2, C angle equal to D angle, beat 3, triangle ABC, congruous to triangle BAD, then beat 4, diagonal AC equal to BD. Okay. Now, here we have to take a construction. That is, extend AB in the direction of B. Extend AB in the direction of B. And throw C, draw a line parallel to AD which meets AB at E. AB at point E. Now we'll come to the next part, that is proof. See here, as already given, AB parallel to CD, and by construction we have taken AD parallel to CE. So AECD is a parallelogram. Write down in AECD quadrilateral is given AP parallel to CD and AD parallel to CE. AD equal to CE by construction. Hence, we can say this implies AECD is a parallelogram. Okay, as AECD is a parallelogram, this implies AD equal to CE. This implies AD equal to CE. But given AD equal to BC, hence we can say BC equal to CE. If BC equal to CE, we can say CBE angle equal to CEB angle. CBE angle equal to CEB angle. Okay, this is one. As angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. Okay, this is one. Again, we can say DAB angle and CEB angle is equal to 180 degree because AD is parallel to CE and AE is the transversal. So write down AD parallel to CE and AE is the transversal. So DAE angle plus DAE angle plus CE A angle, CE A angle equal to 180 degree as angles on the same side of the transversal. Angles on the same side of the transversal are equal. So sorry, equal to supplementary. So instead of CEA, I'll put CBE, already proved in equation 1. This implies DAE angle equal to A plus CBE equal to 180 degree, this is 2, and as from equation 1. So next we'll write CBE angle and CBA angle are, so from 2 and 3, from again we'll write down CBE angle plus CBA angle equal to 180. This is 3, as they are linear pair. So from equation 2 and 3, from equation 2 and 3, right sides are equal as already given 180 degree. So we'll write down DAE angle plus CBE angle equal to CBE angle plus CBA angle. Now both sides CBEs and CBE angle cancel, so we got DAE angle equal to CBA angle, that is A angle equal to B angle. So B1 already proved. We'll write down here BAD angle, or you can say just A angle plus B angle is equal to 180 degree, as AB parallel to DC and AD is the transversal. So we'll write angles on the same side of the transversal. Angles on the same side of the transversal. Okay, same side of the transversal. So again we'll say B angle equal to A plus C angle equal to 180 degree, same region, angles on the same side of the transversal. Angles on the same side of the transversal. So from these two we get A plus D angle, A plus D angle equal to B plus C angle. Okay, but already we proved A angle equal to B angle as A angle equal to D angle. So this implies D angle equal to C angle. We do proved now. We proved in triangle ABC and BAD. In triangle ABC and triangle BAD. So what are the three common points? We'll say AB equal to AB, common side, common side. Okay. Next we say A angle equal to B angle, proved. Okay. And already given AD equal to BC. AD equal to BC given. Already we got three common points in between two triangle. Therefore, we can say triangle ABC, triangle ABC congruent to triangle BAD by SAS. Okay, by SAS criteria. Clear? Now, this implies we can say AC equal to BD by simplicity, which is the point 4, and hence proved. Dear student, this is the end of this exercise 8.1. For latest videos, you have to like, share, subscribe, and press the bell icon for all notifications.